Hey guys, I hope you're having an awesome day. Thank you so much for tuning into this video. I am doing an unboxing of my Zape mystery bag, or I guess unbagging, whatever you want to call it. I'm just going to jump into it. First things first, I did receive their card that says, "Oh hey, gorgeous," with some information on the back. I will leave everything you need to know about this company down below in my description. If you guys want to check them out, highly recommend checking them out. They're amazing. Ashley is great. I love her wax. I love her body care. So this mystery bag was all wax. So there's no body care in this. I believe that there are I don't know if they're called like bubble bags or something like that, which is all body care, mystery body care. But I haven't seen those available since I've been buying from them. But once they do become available, I will probably pick up one of those as well. Okay, so first things first, I did receive a sample, and this sample is in Santal Amadel. I don't know, Santal Amadel. I'm not sure. I could be butchering that. I'm really sorry, guys. This to me smells like it's got like sea salt or like some kind of maybe a little bit of a floral, but it's definitely like a salty sea air, sea salt kind of vibe to it, which you guys know isn't my favorite. But I'm not totally against it. It does have a good summertime vibe. So I'll probably save this and melt it. And if not, then I might just pass it along to like family or friends or something. But if you like those kind of scents, then it's definitely beachy. So another one I picked up before I get into the mystery bag is Get Laid, L-E-I-D, like a lay. this was a part of their Valentine's Day collection. And I don't know why I didn't pick it up the first time. I think it was because I was in the mindset of like, I don't want anything coconut right now. But now my brain has kind of shifted more into spring summertime scents. So I'm there now. And this is coconut, sweet pea, and vanilla. And honestly, I really like this. So you pick up on the coconut like first. It is very coconut. I'm not getting a whole lot of floral in this. And what is a vanilla, right? I guess it adds like a creaminess. To me, this smells like a creamy coconut kind of drink. So it's really nice. I don't know about the sweet pea. This has got like a nice pretty layered wax situation going on. Let me see if I can pop this out. So it's pink on the bottom and then white on the top, and it's got like gold glitter on it. I'm still not picking up on it like any sweet pea, but that could change when melting, like we all know scents do. Okay, so I did open the top of this, but I haven't seen anything inside, so we're just gonna go along together and you'll see my first sniff impressions. I do see some of the names. I'm kind of like reading it already, but I do see some of the names of scents that I already have. But I want to also apologize because it's going to be kind of loud and crinkly and crumply. So sorry about that in advance. First things first, I do see Get Laid in a flower shape. This is the exact same one that I just showed you, same scents and everything. So I'm happy to have a backup. If I don't like it, then I'll just like re-gift it to a friend. And if I do like it, then it'll be nice to have some more. Because typically for me, my own personal, this is what I do with clamshells. I usually use like two at a time in my hot plate warmer because the dish is so large. So that only is like a clamshell, like lasts me like 3 days really, essentially. So I'm happy to have a backup of that scent if I like it. Okay, so the next scent I have is Sweet Surrender. Okay, so this one I do have. I have not melted it yet. And initially on cold sniff, I didn't like it. And I think it was because the strawberry note was just something that I wasn't like a big fan of. However, I melted something, it's a different vendor, but I melted something with a very similar strawberry note and I freaking loved it. So, and I used to hate it. So I don't know, my mind, I think is my nose, not my mind, is kind of changing, and I might end up liking that certain strawberry oil, which I definitely think is the same strawberry oil in this. It's more of a slightly, maybe, I don't want to say green, but like it smells more like a, like the little wild strawberries with the, you know, just picture like the stems on it, that kind of a thing mixed with vanilla, waffle cone, and shortcake. That's what the notes on this are. It's actually shortcake, glazed strawberries, vanilla cream, and waffle cone. I'm sorry, I'm going off on a tangent. Needless to say, I have this. I haven't melted it yet, but I think that I will enjoy this one. So I'm happy to have a backup of that. I'm going to ramble. I ramble all the time. I'm sorry. Okay, so Underoos. This is another one that I have. This is a part of the Valentine's Day collection. And Underoos is glazed donuts, fruity pebbles, cotton candy, and vanilla frosting. And I love this scent, so I'm very happy to have a backup of this one as well. So all winners so far. I'm always nervous with mystery kind of bags, and I'm like too scared of them if they're like too expensive, because then I'm like, I'm not gonna like it. But I feel like this is a good size one to try out. So, okay, this next one here is orange taffy. And there's no scent notes on this. It's in the shape of just like an orange star. Let me sniff it, because I know what the other ones smell like, but I don't know this one. Brand new. Okay. Well, I don't know about taffy. It doesn't smell like an orange candy to me. It kind of smells more like an orange frosting. I guess maybe taffy can be kind of creamy. I guess I'm thinking more like sugary taffy, but I guess I can see it. It definitely smells like a orange frosting to my nose. I like it. It's good. It's not like crazy, like I'd want this in gallons. I mean, that could change. I might melt it and be like, whoa, amazing. But yeah, it's just kind of like a nice sweetened and creamy orange. Kind of like I don't want to say creamsicles, because creamsicles are kind of more like, you can smell like more of the vanilla in it. I don't know. Anyway, orange frosting is what that smells like to me. Okay, the next one here is Pillow Talk. And I didn't pick this one up. Okay, so this one was it says limited edition. Does it say it on the other one? Sorry, I'm moving my curtains all around. Doesn't say limited edition on that. Doesn't say limited edition on these. Oops, I'm dropping stuff. No. Huh. Okay, so I'm not sure if this one is a part of their Valentine's Day collection. Anyway, Pillow Talk. If it is, let me know. This is clean sheets, pomegranate, peach, and flower petals. It does say limited edition, so maybe it wasn't. Okay, it's definitely floral laundry. So I'm not a big floral fan, and I'm not a big laundry fan. So I'm not the biggest fan of it, but it's okay. Obviously I wouldn't keep going back in for more sniffs if I absolutely hated it, but I don't pick up on pomegranate. I pick up on the flower petals and the clean sheets. So it's okay. If you like florals and you like laundry florals, then that one is a good one to try. I'm just going to set this down here. Okay, this one is Oh Sugar Sugar, which I have now. I actually melted this last night. This is vanilla marshmallows, strawberry, and vanilla cotton candy. This one's, at least from when I melted it, I'm putting this one away to cure a little bit longer, and I might I'm letting this one cure a little bit longer in the heart shapes that I got them in originally when I picked this one up. I thought it was just a little bit light, so I'm gonna probably pull this one back out in like the summertime. And this one is nice. It's definitely an authentic kind of sugared spun sugar kind of scent, but it's not super strong on my nose. So I'm definitely gonna let this one sit a little bit longer to work in more of that fragrance oil. Yuletide Carols. Okay, I was not expecting to see any like Christmassy scents, but this is, did I have this one? Let me see. There's no notes on these, so. Oh, yes. Oh, I have this in body care. Sorry, dummy. This is so good. So, yeah, I'm really happy to have this, because this one is like a Christmas tree scent mixed with a vanilla, and it's just like, oh, it's so good. Yeah, I love this. I'm really happy to have this, honestly. This scent I hope comes back next year, Yuletide Carols, and the other scent that I am like crossing every finger that comes back next year is that what is it called? Dun, 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 dun. Tinseltown? Tinseltown. I think it's Tinseltown. That one I hope comes back next year too, because it's so good. Anyway, really happy to have Yuletide Carols. I love that one. This next one here is Ugly Sweater, which I think is going to be another like kind of laundry one. Wait, I have this in body care too, don't I? Yes, I do. In body care, I like it because I think it's more like of a fresh kind of scent and kind of reminds me a little bit of soap. So in body care, I like it. I don't know if I'm gonna love it in a wax form, but I might melt this in the bathroom actually, because I like clean, fresh scents in the bathroom. I like cotton scents or stuff like that. I'm not a huge laundry person, but if I do have them, I will just put them in the bathroom. So this will probably go in the bathroom as well, which is funny because I have this in body care in my bathroom right now. So that one is good to have. Next one I have here is Peppermint Candy. And I don't remember this one at all. Oh, this just smells like candy canes. It's very creamy. It's definitely almost like a buttermint kind of peppermint, because I get like a little bit of like that extra creaminess that you get with buttermints. I like that. And I'm not, that's coming from somebody that's like not huge on peppermint, especially like out of season, which now I technically think we are like out of that season of peppermint. So I like it. It's really nice. Probably will save that one, but I don't know. We'll see. Okay. Oh, okay. This one I wanted to try, but just haven't picked up on my own. This is Date with an Englishman. And I heard a lot of good things about this, which is why I kind of wanted to pick it up. I don't like rose. You guys probably know that. But this is rose petals, vanilla bean, and pipe tobacco, which I do like pipe tobacco. So this one might be good. Either I'll love it or I'll hate it. So we'll see. Oh, okay. Not my favorite. I do smell a lot of rose. So you have to probably love rose. It's okay. It's kind of, roses remind me of my grandma. Just like, because she had like a big pink tub of like body powder. I don't even know what you call it. It was just like a body powder with like this big poofy pad thing, I don't know what you call it. And it always just smells, she just smelled like this, not like the pipe tobacco. This just really just smells like my grandma's powder puff that she would wear. So yeah, it's kind of nice. I think that this is something that I would have to like really be like in the mood for, I guess. Not necessarily something I would pick up in loaves or buckets or whatever. Just, yeah, if you like rose, you might like that. Okay, next thing is Holidays, which do I have this one still, or did I give this to a friend? Let me sniff. So Holidays was a part of their holiday winter collection. Ooh. Wait. Did I? This is Holly Berry's Woody Christmas Greens, Juicy Apple, Ripe Raspberries, and Sweet Plum. Yes, I melted all the way through this one, which is fine because I used it all up. So I'll just stick this in my thing for next year. This is a cute shape. It's like a little snowflake and it's green. Also, I haven't even been showing you the cute shapes. This is like a rose or a tulip maybe. I don't think it's not a rose. Sorry. This one's like a tulip. This is the English gentleman one. How cute is that? I think it's cute. And they're all fairly cute shapes too. So anyway, this one I did finish. This was in like my last month's empties. And this one I melted in the bathrooms, and this one has a very similar note. The note of the holly berries kind of reminded me of one of their Valentine's Day collection scents, which is Swack. The berries in this, I think, are the same. I don't know, that's what my nose smells. But this is definitely much more green and stuff. I like this one. This one's really good. I'm happy to have more of this. I won't be melting this until next year, probably, because of the season that we're in. But it's good. I'm happy to have that one. This is peony, just peony, no notes on it. So let's see if I can handle. Some flowers I really can't, like rose, some I can. Oh, this smells like my grandma too. I like it. I just, Yeah, I just the floor. I'm not a huge floral person, but this does like remind me of my grandma. This one and the date with a English gentleman or whatever, that smells like my grandma too. So, honestly, I feel like if you love florals, then you probably love this because it's like a really nice, soft, sweet, pretty floral. I don't know. It's nice. Rose is sometimes like, ooh, but like that peony is a little bit more. It smells like spring, but also my grandma. My grandma in the spring. It smells like that. So it's good. Okay, and finally, is this my last one? Yes. Okay, so finally I have sweet buns. And sweet buns is sticky cinnamon buns, buttercream icing, and sweet maple. And I do have this one in a, why can't I think of it? Like the full size, which I think is just these two, this shape twice, is how it came. I can't remember. Haven't melted this one yet, but I like this one on cold. It's just like a super delicious, like buttery bun type of scent with like a little hint of cinnamon sugar. That's what my nose picks up on, at least. So I'm happy to have this one. Honestly, overall, I would say for the price I paid, which was $21 for all of this, I think that's a great price. And I only didn't like, which didn't like, but I only didn't love a couple of them, which some of them are just things that I might gift, you know, to some friends or stuff. Yeah, the Date with the English Gentleman, if you love florals. Or if you love rose, specifically rose, this is, I pick up on the rose right away. And then peony, I think I will be able to melt definitely easier than I could for like this rose one because it's a little bit more of like a softer springtime scent floral. But these two are like the only ones that I'm kind of more like not 100% about. But the rest of them, I'm happy. I love it. And I'm very pleased overall. Would I repurchase another mystery box from Zape? Yeah, 100% I would. I think this is great. I have more wax than I know what to do with. So I probably should like take a break from a little while and only purchase the things that I'm like gung-ho about. But I'm really happy. And there were definitely a few that not more than a few. There's definitely a lot that I didn't have here. So I'm happy to have those. Okay, so that is it. Thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you're having an amazing day, staying safe and happy. Bye guys.